Hi, I'm James Brown with Amptweaker, and this is our new TightDrive Pro. Check it out. Okay, here's the TightDrive Pro. I've got it set up with the swirl pool in the sidetrack loop, although it's turned off, and the carbon copy delay is in the boost loop with it set on post. So here's the clean sound. Your pedal set as close to clean as you can get. Okay. At this setting, you can hear that it's just slightly broken up with this American Fender Strat. Start turning the gain up. One thing you can do with this pedal is, since it'll get so clean, you can just use it kind of as a clean boost by setting it this way and then turning the master up. And then you can also set the boost on the boost for an additional volume boost there. Could kick on this delay, and that's your clean tone. Here's your, and then when you go to the solo, so there's just a quick, easy way to use it as just a clean boost. And of course, most people will start there, and then you can add amounts of boost as you want, however much gain. So back to just the standard. Now there's some switches on the inside, and one that's turned off on the rhythm sound is a fat switch on the inside. There's two of them, one for rhythm and one for boost. Right now I've got the boost set with it on and the rhythm without it. So here's the difference. If I just hit the boost set up like it is, then all you're hearing is the amount of that fat. So you can just use that for just a different tone if you want. Another thing you can kick on with the boost is the mid boost over here, which boosts obviously the mid range when you hit this boost. So now you got, kind of like three different tones, not necessarily three different volumes. Okay. Now let's go through some of the distortion sounds you can get out of this thing. Here's just a little more gain like I showed earlier. We'll turn the master back down. You clean that. Here's max gain, cleaned up on the guitar. Now this is with the gain switch off, so it's not maximum pedal gain, but it's the maximum on this low setting. Guitar up. So there I'm working the volume on the guitar and showing you how good it cleans up. Then if you want just a little more gain, kick on the boost with the volume set about halfway. Now that's starting to get a little bit loud. So what we did on this one, the boost is set up with a cut and a boost on the volume control. That way, if you're on this cleaner setting, you can turn that boost gain up but to boost volume down so you can sort of balance the volume like this. Balances the volume pretty good. Then if you just, and then of course when you go for the higher gain settings, you'll probably not need to cut this volume because there's not so much dynamics when you're playing heavier. Now, let me show you some of the different tones you can get here. Here's the Plex EQ switch. Now at the lower gain settings, it's just going to kind of sound real bright. But as you turn it up and go for heavier sounds, it's going to sound more like you're cranking up an old Plexi Marshall or something like that. Which are very clean amps when you play them low. Smooth edge. This is helpful for getting more of a tube screamery top end where you're not so sizzly. If you're going for heavier sounds, you probably want to kick this on because it'll start getting kind of harsh. But at this setting, it sounds pretty good either way. Depends on what your guitar, of course, and all that kind of stuff. Okay, now, here's the noise gate. I've got it set kind of moderate, not real heavy on the gate because I don't want it to mess with the sound too much, but it can be set heavier. And this is a new noise gate that doesn't add any distortion. It just cuts off the signal when you're not playing. Eventually it does sort of chop off the note at the end. This automatically tracks the gain control. So as you turn the gain control up higher, it works harder. If you turn it down lower, it automatically cleans it up some so that you don't have to think about all that stuff when you just kick it on. Okay, and of course when you go for the high gain, it goes to a harder setting as well. Okay, now let me show you the tight control. Notice I've got it turned down. Most low end you can have. Now on the cleaner settings you might think, well, why would you ever turn this up because it just starts sounding thin. And it is different when you turn the tight up than when you turn the low up. They both affect the low end, but one, the tight is in front of the circuit, so it's more like changing your guitar. You can think about this as being a British tone over here on the right and an American tone on the left. Most of your Fender stuff has always had a lot of low end, so with this you can kind of convert it to a Vox by turning this up. Varying amounts, which is something you don't get with those two amps. You turn it up, you might want to turn the bass back up some. See how that makes it kind of balance out. It's really helpful if you're playing chunky rhythm stuff. Sometimes the low end will sound a little bit gargly when you chunk kind of hard with it. And you can particularly hear that when you're going for the heavier sounds. Speaking of heavier sounds, why don't I hit that gain switch right here so we can see what that's all about. That's usually where I like to leave things, is with the gain set to high. So this is the maximum. That's the maximum gain with the switch off. Here's the maximum. Maximum with it on. Okay. Noise gate. Okay, noise gate works good. I'm gonna leave it off even though it's a little noisy, just because I want you to hear natural decays and stuff like that. So here you can start noticing the tight when I turn this up. See how much chunkier it gets. So I can turn this up and the low with it. And now is where I start wanting this edge switch turned on. That's still cleaned up on the guitar. Okay, and then here's the boost on. Now you can see that you kind of want to turn this back up some. So that kind of helps balance it. And of course, if you want more of a solo boost, turn this on up. Okay, that's kind of some of the sounds. Let's go with this plexi cue sound, see what that does. Kick on the delay with the gain, and you can tweak out the volume and the gain of your solo boost to whatever you want. Okay, here I'll turn the noise gate on because it is a little bit hissy at that point when you go for a lot of gain. We'll be right back. Basically, with this one pedal, you can control your whole sound. You can put anything you want in the sidetrack to set up a clean sound or whatever kind of sound you want to go back to when you turn this off. And then whatever you want while this is on, you can either patch in the universal loop to control other effects that you want to blend with this, like say you always use a doubler or something like that, or a chorus with your distortion. You can put that in there. And then whenever you want, when the boost comes on, you can patch whatever you want in here, like a delay in this case. Another thing people will do sometimes is they might want a little more gain than this. So you can set the boost loop on pre, and then you can put one of our other drive pedals in that loop to drive the distortion in here even harder. So I hope that's a pretty good explanation and kind of shows you some of the tones you can get with it. I'll just play a little bit more here with the basic sounds, and obviously you'll get different results with different amps, and this is just one example of a Strat with a Princeton, and that's about it. Go out and buy one. All right, here's some more tones. Smooth up and then still turn the highs up to get some high end back, and it's just a different kind versus just a little chunkier that way. This way it's a little more smooth, I think. About showed you everything. I guess I could show you the most metal sound you can get out of this thing, because some guys like more of a classic metal tone that's not so heavy. And of course, the way you do that, first you turn the gain all the way up, obviously. Then you turn the highs down to here. Crazy with the boost gain. TightDrive Pro. Thanks.